because we're going to talk about the GOAT versus the Golden Boy. And I love that topic from our producer, Ben. He's always coming up with these great topic names. But it honestly could be arguably be called the GOAT versus the Baby GOAT, because I think Mahomes is just, you know, positioning himself to be in that situation and be in that talk for the future.
No question. I think you've got the greatest quarterback of all time going up against the current best quarterback in the NFL. So you've got a guy who has done everything on the football field, but somehow this year he's kind of stepped it up and done one more thing, one more notch on Brady's belt, especially if he wins this one with a completely different team. And then you've got Pat Mahomes, who just won the Super Bowl and is now, we talked about before, how Rodgers still hasn't gotten that second Super Bowl. If Mahomes wins this one, now you're starting to say, you know, I think people already thought he was going to be in the top 10 of quarterbacks all time. Now, if he wins two, he's definitely in there because he's going to be good for years to come, you know, barring any kind of injury. And then after that, it's like, now is he going to get to the top five? You know, because I think you can start to even discuss that, even though it's still very early in his career. But I'm excited to see these two guys. Mahomes is so talented throwing the football. Everybody knows that. He can throw sidearm. He can throw from all different angles. He's got a rocket for an arm. His accuracy is unbelievable. But then you've got Brady, who can't quite – who still looks good. At 43, he can still sling it, just not anywhere near a Mahomes or a Josh Allen. I still think Rodgers' arm is a little bit stronger than Brady's at this point, but can still sling it, and he's got great receivers just like Mahomes does. So it's going to be – I think it's going to be a duel. Both defenses have been playing pretty well. I actually think Tampa Bay's defense might be a little bit better than Kansas City's. Having Bush back – White back in the middle of that defense, he's been unbelievable for Tampa Bay. And then their defensive line's been really good. We forget the talented players on that defensive line with Ndamukong Suh, Jason Pierre-Paul, plenty of guys there to talk about as well. So you know, it's going to be a fun matchup, but just to, going into it, the two quarterbacks are going to be the headline. It's going to be whenever you have two otherworldly quarterbacks like we're going to see on Super Bowl Sunday, it's always a lot of fun.
Yeah, I think Brady has really defined himself even more as the greatest quarterback of all time, getting himself to a 10th Super Bowl with a new team when people were doubting him. I think the Patriots look like idiots at this point. I mean, and they look cheap. They look cheap right now. You're going to offer this guy a little bit more money. You couldn't put any weapons around him. And now look at you. You're sitting at home. This guy's taking himself to another Super Bowl at 43 years old. So, I mean, that's just me venting a little bit as a Patriots fan. But you look cheap, man. You look cheap. You look cheap. You look stupid. This guy is proving you wrong yet again. He's proven many of us wrong. And I, like I said, even to one, at one point last year, I was saying he lost a little zip on the ball, but he's proven me wrong to that point. And I think the weapons do help, though. Having the weapons, like we've talked about many a times, if he had those weapons in New England, I think we'd be in the Super Bowl right now if he had stayed. And he would have stayed if we had given him the money that he wanted and the weapons around him. But, yeah, I think this is, like I said, he's defined himself more as the greatest quarterback of all time. Patrick Mahomes is definitely putting himself in the conversation of top 10 quarterbacks. And I think that's, you know, on the rise. His stock is completely on the rise. If he can completely keep on this ascending roll that he's on, I think you could easily see him in the top five, especially if he keeps winning titles. And I think Andy Reid's going to put him in position to win titles, I think, for at least the next couple of years and for the foreseeable future. I think you have two different quarterbacks here. You have obviously a one quarterback who's going to rely more on his age, his experience, being able to break down defenses and read coverages and then utilize his weapons, go to the check down. And then you have Patrick Mahomes, who's just really a generational quarterback, can get outside. He can move the pocket. He can run if he needs to get you that first down. He can throw sidearm like it's his second job. I mean, this guy is unbelievable. I think he's a great player. We've talked about him a lot on the show. We'll talk about him many, many more times. But this is I'm looking forward to this Super Bowl, not only just because of those two guys, but like you said, I think the Bucs defense is playing amazing right now. White is playing unbelievable right now. He played great in that championship game, that NFC championship game. So I think we truly are getting the two best teams right now. And I think it's crazy because Tampa Bay was a fifth seed, and they played through that wild card, but we've talked about how they've really come on in the second half of the season. And I think this is one of the few times that you can say in the Super Bowl we're truly getting the two best teams right now playing at their best. And I'm really looking forward to it. And obviously, the two quarterbacks are going to be the headlining story.
Right. I think, you know, I don't think it's a huge shock that the Chiefs are in the Super Bowl with what Mahomes has been able to do. And then with the Bucs, it was, you know, this is already a shortened offseason. You've got a couple new guys. Oh, by the way, your quarterback's brand new, and he's been in another system that's basically been the same for the past two decades. Yet Brady comes in. They cater things to Brady a little bit. It took a little while to really get there. But you saw during the end of the year, they won four straight. Not great competition, but they won four straight and then just kept it rolling during the playoffs. Got a little bit of lucky with the seeding, but I think they would have beat anybody they played in the NFC this year. They beat the best team in the NFC, which I thought was the Green Bay Packers. So unbelievable that those two quarterbacks are going to be matching up to the Super Bowl. It's going to be a lot of fun talking about and then watching it on Super Bowl Sunday.